Is microdosing backed by science?
In this thesis, I will.
You know, I'm something of a scientist myself.
Is microdosing backed by science? And what science do we have to back up microdosing? Welcome back to my microdose series. Today we are going to be talking about the science and the studies behind microdosing magic mushrooms. So yes, we do have the hard science to back psilocybin mushroom journeys of a moderate to high dose.
Okay!
We are in the early years of microdosing studies. It's not to say they haven't been done, it's just to say that their results prove to be slightly less conclusive because they are not backed by other studies. And the funds and the resources to support these studies are limited, so these studies definitely have their limitations. I've done one video so far on is microdosing magic mushrooms placebo? And that goes a little bit more into depth on that placebo study, but in this video, I will be talking a little bit more extensively about a couple other studies as well. I am Chrysantilus, and if you're new here, welcome. We are a realm dedicated to psychedelics and sacred plant medicine, all about demystifying and destigmatizing the trip. If you dig this video, please subscribe to this channel. You can also find me on Instagram, TikTok, and Patreon. At Chrysantilus.
The following video is made for the purpose of education and harm reduction. We are not promoting the use, procurement, or possession of any plant medicine or substance. We encourage everyone to do further research and prioritize safety.
So, does it matter if microdosing is backed by science or not? Let me know what you think in the comments section. For me, I have felt the improvements of microdosing in my daily life. It has eliminated my anxiety. It has severely decreased my depression. So even if it was placebo, that at this point doesn't too much matter to me because it's doing something.
It's actually helpful.
I think it does matter in terms of a larger scale, getting funding, decriminalization, all of these other routes for finding resources, for getting microdoses to the masses. But for me personally, it's helpful. And whether the science says that that helpfulness is placebo or not, it doesn't really matter at this point. I've been microdosing mushrooms for a year. To me, it's doing something. The first study we're going to talk about today is from Leiden University. It's a university in the Netherlands by a researcher called Hommel. Hommel specifically studied creativity and problem solving in conjunction with microdosing magic mushrooms. So I'm gonna read a little bit of this study. Whatever the dose, psilocybin binds to the receptors for the neurotransmitter serotonin. The cortex is packed with these 5-HT2A receptors, especially in areas that control reflection, imagination, and introspection. But whether there is a minimum dose of psilocybin that is required to activate them is an empirical question that we try to tackle. Essentially, we know that the girls are getting it done. We know that the girls are doing these things.
The girls that get it, and the girls that don't, don't.
But how many of the girls do we need to actually know that the things are getting done? Like, what is the minimum amount of girls? And can a microdose be enough? Can a microdose be enough to make significant improvements beyond just like a placebo? We don't know what the minimum amount would be for the girls to be getting it. And like I mentioned in some of my other videos in the series, microdosing magic mushrooms has been particularly helpful to me in my creativity, in my creative problem solving of life's obstacles and challenges, as well as in certain struggles like writer's block. Magic mushroom microdoses can be a guiding hand to hold when you are creatively struggling or looking for creative solutions of what am I gonna do? How am I gonna pay this rent? How am I gonna feel better? For me, magic mushroom microdoses have really like directed my attention to a very specific place. And I'm like, okay, I see a solution. I didn't think it was possible, but I see a solution. That brings me around to the second study. The second study, and I get into this a little bit more are in some of my other videos, but it's by Anderson, Petranker, and Hapke. And in their study of microdosing magic mushrooms, they were able to find some pros and also some cons, which I think is very fascinating, right? Because we don't really be hearing about the cons. A lot of the times, it's just a world of pros. In their study, they found a 26.6% improved mood. That, I think, would reflect my experience. My mood improvement has been night and day when I'm microdosing versus when I'm not. When I'm microdosing, I feel so much better, probably greater than 26% better than how I feel when I'm not microdosing. And they also cite finding a 14.8% increase in focus, which I think that's totally accurate. I additionally take ADHD medication, never on the same day that I take my microdose. And microdoses definitely are not as strong at assisting me in focus as my ADHD medication is. So that 14.8%, that sounds right. And then lastly, they found an 18% increase in physiological discomfort, which I found very fascinating. I haven't had any physiological discomfort in microdosing, or I've heard of other people having that, but that's really fascinating to me that this is something that was found in a study, that people felt not very comfortable while doing a microdose. And I wonder where that comes from. And then lastly, we have the double-blind microdose study. I've done a bigger in-depth video on these double-blind microdose studies, right? Because they have found that psilocybin is not potentially stronger than the placebo effect. Like, psilocybin works, yes, but people who are also taking what they think is psilocybin, it works there as well. So is microdosing backed by science? I would say not quite yet, but we are getting there in terms of like overall improvement and different studies pointing to the same specific overall improvements. Right now we have studies pointing like creativity, yes, or mood increase, yes, but not quite better than the placebo, or focus quite a bit, yes, but I feel like in the next few years we're really gonna get a streamline of studies backing other studies, and that's just gonna be so dope to see. So I have a quote here, and this is from, I believe it's Michael Van Elk, who did the double-blinded study, and that study showed, quote, "We found that microdosing with psilocybin compared to a placebo did not result in reduced depression or anxiety scores," Van Elk told SciPost. "We observed a strong generic placebo effect, though. Both the placebo and the microdosing group showed a significant change in their well-being scores from the moment they started with the study. Merely expecting that you are part of a clinical trial during which you might or might not receive a psychoactive substance already improves your well-being." End quote. So essentially, whether you were actually getting the microdose or not, it didn't really make a difference. What made a difference was you thinking that you were in a clinical trial, a clinical study where you had the potential to have a microdose that severely improved your well-being and eliminated some of your depression, reduced some of your anxiety, all of that good stuff. That study, I think, was very disappointing to a lot of people in the psychedelic community, but to me, it made total sense. The placebo effect is very stigmatized, but I also think that it can be very real and it can have actually like life-saving effects. We underestimate the power of the mind on a daily basis to heal us on its own without real actual external help. So even when this help was not truly external, even when it was internal, it was still helping. And I don't think that this discounts the benefits and the help of microdosing. I think like everybody in the study could have heard like such great things about microdosing that they wanted to make that true for themselves. And I think that we just need more research and more scientific studies to say something once and for all. But I mean, at the end of the day, it's not about the studies. It's not necessarily about the science only. It's also about our own experiences with these medicines and how we can be of service to the medicine, and the medicine can in turn be of service to us. You know, it's all about us reciprocating this mutual relationship with the medicine. So I don't think it's only about science, but I like to keep my eye on where the science is with all of this stuff. So those are three studies, Everything is linked in my description. And if you learned something today in this video, please be sure to subscribe to this channel. We are making our way to 10,000 subscribers. I also have merch for y'all available on my Threadless. Super cute, keep it trippy stuff. I design all of it myself. I also recently just soft launched a Patreon, so please go check that out if you are a fan or a stan. If you are in community and keep coming back to these videos time after time, you can find me on TikTok and Instagram. I am at Chrysantilus. And yeah, if you have any other questions or need clarification on any of this, let me know in the comments section. And don't forget to keep it trippy. Peace.